Okay, let's go again. By the way, I'll be playing in the British Championship Major Open this year. I didn't manage to qualify for the main British Championship. I had two chances, one at Southend and one at Ilford. I was doing well at Southend in the end, but it wasn't good enough to... It's very hard, actually, to qualify from one of these Open tournaments. Intuitive 2401. I don't like his opening very much, the exchange French, with nagging pressure. I wonder, bishop g4 here, is that too risky? The idea of, knight d7, queen c7, c5, I've got bishop f4, I suppose. Try and castle queenside. Was it better to take on c4 first? Then knight d7 to b6. Then bishop f7 on, knight g5 and queen g4. Sorry, knight d7 here. And neutralize this bishop, bishop g6. So queen c7 on knight c5. Bishop f4, queen e2, king's kind of trapped. This is knight f6 there. Maybe it is time to take on c4 now. Then knight b6. I'll take on c4. Play knight b6 here. Queen c7, under a castle queenside. I don't like c5 anymore. okay. He's going to get the dark square bishop. It's a bit unpleasant, that's why I've got bishop e4. Bishop f4. I can play bishop f4. Yeah, that's better than bishop e4. And castle queenside, it'll be nice blockade maybe on this nice like queen pawn. Quite losing f7. Castle here. Yeah. Oh, forgot about that. Oh well. Under h5. Seems to be quite annoying pressure from that exchange match. Kind of very dangerous. You'd think it is joyous, but in practice can be incredibly dangerous. At knight d5 here. At least if rook b7, there'll be rook c5. That takes rook d5, rook b7, rook c5. Perhaps. Or is there rook takes g5 threatened here? Takes, queen takes, and queen takes e7. Well, if that's the case, then also rook d8, maybe to threaten rook takes c5. I think on the whole knight takes b7, no rook g5. Well, given this threat of mating, guess I should take. Right, what to do about this? b6? b6, there might be, Queen c4. Takes Queen a6. I'm probably getting mated there. Is anything clever here? b5. I think b6. Okay. Very clinical play. That's Bishop f5. Yeah. Taking on f7 is just killing, I think. I'll resign that. Oh well. Exchange French. Amazing. So much pressure. Just after this c4. Just seems, I don't know, the king was like trapped in the centre. After the knight e4, e7's vulnerable. So this g4, he's actually pinned my knight. And it's like intense pressure. I don't know. Also, b7's under fire. It looks like lost there. I don't know, that's the check with Ripka, but it looks. No, king f8. Second b7 pawn, then h5. Maybe that's playable. Oh well. Please leave any comments or questions on YouTube. Thanks very much. Just as an interesting addendum, I've been looking at. The history of Intuitive, and he's got a massive string of wins here, and the only people he's lost to recently are Wayfiri and Ananin, who I happen to lose to recently as well. That's interesting. Otherwise there's a massive string of wins to get to this 2400 level. So against Ananin, I don't know if we examine this game quickly. Let's have a quick flick through. So, Groomfield. Was it colored bishop? Thing. Oh, okay. White managed to win a piece there. After this, bishop f2 just took. Right, so this didn't work out. Oh well. And against Wayfiri, if we examine that. So Wayfiri was black. And yeah. That's got a lot of counterplay, it seems here. Breaks open the centre. Rook takes h5, nice. Move to win the queen. Alright, just thought I'd let you know that. That was interesting because those are the two opponents I lost to recently as well. So Intuitive, very strong in the 2400s. Thanks very much.